rubber, it's everywhere. Tires, iPod cases, basketballs, even the soles of your shoes. We live in a world insulated and protected by rubber. Back in the 1800s, rubber was just becoming popular, except for one problem. The cold winter air would make it hard and inflexible, and in the summer, it became a sticky, gooey mess. One man would change all that. His wife's kitchen became a laboratory. His family possessions were pawned, and without any sort of chemical training or education, he struggled through dozens, hundreds, and eventually thousands of chemical experiments. All of this to make rubber useful. Most of us would consider such an endeavor a silly waste of time. But for this man, it was a journey of faith. He felt like he was on a mission from God to solve the mysterious melting rubber problem. And eventually, he did. He discovered the formula to galvanize rubber and make it a useful resource to the entire world. Charles Goodyear was the name of this passionate Christ follower. His name is familiar today because it is stamped on millions of tires, and the Goodyear Tire and Rubber Company is the largest in the world. But Charles Goodyear never got rich from his little discovery. He actually lived on the edge of financial ruin until his death in 1860. 4 decades later, Goodyear Tire and Rubber Company was founded by people who weren't even related to him. But the impact of this one man's discovery can be seen everywhere. Here's a man that followed God and followed his passion, not for personal glory, but because of faith. The truth is that God calls people to unusual tasks. Whether it's building an ark, breaking down a wall, retrieving a donkey, or discovering new things, God calls you to live on the cusp for Him. Whatever your passion, God wants to use it and you to glorify Him.